Hey, I'm Grim Grindle, and welcome to this video. Every time I see someone complaining about Banjo-Kazooie nuts and bolts, they're complaining that the game just doesn't have enough platforming, and that there's too heavy a focus on vehicles. And that really got me thinking, why not, if you don't like the vehicles, just not use them? So in this video, I decided to see how many challenges in Banjo-Kazooie nuts and bolts I could complete to the degree of actually receiving a jiggy without driving a single vehicle. And yes, before you complain, I am well aware that my banjo is fully upgraded and you can't have such a highly upgraded banjo unless you've actually finished the game with vehicles, yada yada yada. It's all just supposed to be a bit of fun. Kindly unknot your knickers. So let's see how I did. It's going to be a lot of video game footage now without me talking, so I'll see you on the other side. And if you just want to see the results and not the experiment, click the timestamp on the screen right now and it'll take you straight to the end of the video where I'll start talking again.
Now, Like... Oh. Hey! Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey!
Thank you. No. right.
Red.
And we're back to me talking. So there you have it, 34 jiggies without a single vehicle used. 36 if you include the two extra ones you would have gotten for achieving 8 Trophy Thomas times. It's also probably quite possible to score quite a few more, but I was limiting myself to only 3 attempts per challenge, simply because I wanted to get this video done before the new year. If you've played a lot of Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, I suggest you give it a crack just for fun. It's an interesting new way to play the game, pretty gosh darn challenging, and some levels like Berry Ripe Indeed are actually pretty difficult platformers. I did, however, admittedly find myself missing the Talon Trot. I reckon if I had Banjo and Kazooie's movesets from Banjo-Tooie, I would have probably been able to complete all the challenges bar a few. Regardless, it was a fun experiment and kinda made me wish I could try Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie with vehicles. If you enjoyed my little experiment of playing the game in a way you're not really supposed to, like the video and subscribe for more later on. After finishing this video, I had a look on YouTube to see if anyone else had attempted a similar challenge, and it does indeed seem that a gentleman by the name of Hextator has also done quite a few no-vehicle challenges. So if you want to see more no-vehicle challenges, I've got a link to his playlist on the left-hand side. Or if you want to see more of my Nuts and Bolts videos, the link is on the right-hand side. And as always, thanks for watching, and until next time, I have been and still am Grim Grindle, and you have been watching the Nuts and Bolts No Vehicle Challenge.